right down. The next topic, resonance. Resonance in series LCR circuit. Okay. What is the current you get if you supply voltage V naught? You get I naught equals to V naught divided by yes omega L minus 1 by omega C square plus R square. What is this?
Incidence.
This is the peak current. Fine. Now, this peak current is fixed for a given frequency. But if you change frequency, omega, will peak current change? Will impedance change if you change omega? It will change, right? And there will be one frequency for which XC will become equal to XL. And that moment you will have maximum of the maximum current. This is the maximum current at a particular frequency. This maximum current can also be varied if you change omega. So the maximum current's maximum will happen when XC become equal to XL, I naught will be maximum. So how much the I naught will become?
R.
V naught by R.
V naught by R. Fine. And what frequency is it when XC becomes equal to XL? How much? Omega L equals to 1 by omega C. So omega becomes?
Omega 1 by root LC.
So omega becomes 1 by root L into C. So if you have this frequency, then current will be the maximum possible. Fine. This is the resonance condition. This is where the resonance happens. Now we will be using this resonance condition in one of the instruments. Okay, for example, see, for example, if you have a radio, have you ever seen that analog radio where you rotate the knob and this thing goes from 90 megahertz and it goes to 100? You have not seen it, that radio. When you rotate the knob, what happens is that you change the value of capacitance. You don't change omega actually. Omega is fixed. Okay? So when you change the knob, capacitance changes, and there will be some value of capacitance for which omega 1 by omega C becomes equal to omega L in that circuit. So in that circuit, resonance will happen then. And once the resonance happens, it will happen at a particular frequency. And if you're getting signal of that frequency, suppose you want to listen a song like 92 FM, okay, that has a fixed frequency. So if at that frequency resonance happens, then the peak current will be corresponding to that particular frequency. Getting it? And other frequency current will be minimal. So the other frequency is your noise, and the peak current, where the maximum of the maximum current comes, where XC becomes equal to XL, this is where the point where you'll get the maximum signal. And if that resonance happens at 92 FM, you'll get a station 92 FM in your radio. Fine? I mean, it will not be understood just like that. I mean, I'm just giving you a rough picture of how it functions and why it is practically used, right? Now, in order to get into the details of exactly how radio is built and how it operates and all, it's a month long thing, fine. So if you plot a graph between frequency omega and the peak current, let's say I naught, okay, you will get a graph something like this. What will be this frequency? Resonant frequency. At this frequency, the maximum current is the maximum. Fine. So this point, the current corresponds to V naught by R. Okay. Now tell me one thing. You want this kind of resonance or this kind of resonance? Which one will be best for you? One or two?
For what, sir?
Two.
Right? In order to catch the signal, two is the best. Why?
If you change a little bit, it'll still just slowly go up, as in two will just.
In one, you are still catching frequency from here to here with a substantial amount of current. So you'll have more noise. But here, it is a sharp resonance. The resonance is sharp over here. So if you catch this signal, you'll be able to sharply catch it. The other frequency or the noise will be minimal over here. Getting it? See, basically you are catching everything. Are you getting my point? You are catching all the frequency, but this particular frequency has a maximum current, and other noise in this curve 1 will have substantial current, so you will hear a lot of background noise. But in curve number 2, other frequencies have very less current. If you decrease little bit, your current will just go down from here to here. Fine, but if you decrease little bit, current from here will go there. Are you getting it? If you change frequency. So that is why 2 is preferred over 1. Why? Because it is more sharp. Okay. Now, in order to understand the quality of this resonance, one is qualitatively, you just look at the graph, okay, this is better and that is better. Okay. But then it is as good as saying that some object is heavy and some object is light. Does it make any sense? This doesn't convey a lot of meaning. Okay, something which is heavy to you may be lighter for someone else. Fine, this is just qualitatively we are saying something is better, something is not. It is your own perspective. Fine, there might be a better resonance than this. Okay, so we need to assign a number to what is the quality of resonance. Fine. Until we give a value, like for example, we give, okay, this is 5 kg and that is 10 kg. That makes much more sense than just saying that something is heavy and other thing is light. Okay, so that is why we need to come up with a factor called quality factor, which determines what is the quality of the resonance in these circuits. Okay, so next, I mean, in continuation of this only, next subtopic is quality factor. This is also just referred as Q factor, or it is also referred as sharpness of the resonance. Does it make sense? Sharper the resonance, better the quality of resonance. Fine. Now, how you define sharpness of anything? How it get determined? Suppose you have two objects. This is one object. Okay. And you have another object. which is more sharp? Two guys, one guy is just 4 feet, okay? The width is suppose 1.5 feet, other guy is 7 feet, width is 2 feet. Whom you will think that it's fatter and who will you think it is thinner?
4 feet.
You'll say 4 feet also. It's a comparison between length and width that matter. You won't just see the width.
So
are you getting it? So this is sharper in a way. Even though this width is more than this. So you compare what is the width relative to what is the length. Okay. Now, in order to find out the sharpness of resonance, we need to first define the width. Getting it? So suppose I want to find out sharpness of this curve. Let me draw. Suppose this is the curve for which I want to determine what is the sharpness. First, I need to define what is the width of this. Now, how will you define the width? Width is continuously changing. What do you think? How should we do that?
Are you there in terms of a change of width by change of...
Okay. But I want to keep it simple, very, very simple.
At the bottom and at the peak,
mm-hmm.
at the lowest end and at the peak, right?
I want to make it more simple.
Can you take a small d value?
See, you can assume any width. This one, this one, this one, this one.
But it's
if it is sharper, at every point, their width will be less than the width of this. Yes or no? Right? So you can take any point and say that is the width. And what makes more sense? Which width we should take?
The top piece.
So, like topmost is zero width.
Somewhere in the middle.
Where exactly do you think it is?
Middle and above. Because that's why it's
not. Where? Tell me the value.
V0 by 2.
V0 by root 2R.
Isn't that I?
No. I0 is V0 by R.
Isn't that I?
V0
by root 2R we will be taking up. Somewhat related to what we have been doing till now. Okay? It is like RMS value of the peak currents. So you will draw a horizontal line at a current of V0 by root 2 times R. Fine? And you will say that this is the width. Okay, and since it is symmetrical about this line, I'll say that this one is delta omega and that is also delta omega. Delta omega and delta omega. Total width is 2 delta omega. Any doubt? Now tell me, this is how you define the width. How will you define the length? One thing will come in your mind, okay, this looks like a length. This is like a mountain, so I'll say that this is the length. Okay? But that's not how it should be. That's not how it should be. When you found out the sharpness, what you did? You divided length from the width.
So you divide by 1 by root.
So,
you divide it by omega. You have to keep it dimensionless.
You have divided
the length from other length to find the sharpness.
Yeah.
Okay. Here also you divide 2 times delta omega from omega. See, if the resonance is happening at 5 hertz, and delta omega is 3 hertz. It's a very blunt resonance. It's not a good resonance, yeah. Isn't it? But if frequency is 1000 and delta omega is 5, then it is good resonance. You have to compare with respect to omega, how much is delta omega?
So the more the difference, the better the resonance is, the quality is.
No, less is the difference. Less is this width, better is the quality. Fine? So we define, see the thing is, it's not a something which is given by God. It is our own creation. We have assumed that, okay, let's call Q factor as omega divided by 2 delta omega. Are you getting it? You can say, no, I'll call it omega divided by omega square divided by delta omega square. It's your own wish. But everybody has agreed to, you know, to call quality factor as omega divided by 2 delta omega. Everybody has agreed to say that, okay, Newton's second law of motion is force equal to mass and acceleration. If Newton would have said that, no, force equal to mass into acceleration square, all the things are still valid. I mean, you can start from there and build the entire mechanics backwards. Because force equal to mass and acceleration, that is why momentum is m into v, and that is why you are able to solve these questions like that. Had it been m into a square, the entire mechanics you would have been studying in a different way. Fine, so it is our own creation. What do you call? Similarly, work done. Work done is not, the formula is not the God's creation. Formula is our own creation. Similarly here, we will just assume a formula which makes physical sense as the formula of any physical variable.
So, but we derived it, right? So that will be the law, right? So we can't change that.
Because we have all agreed to assume.
You're saying it's a hypothetical situation.
We have all assumed to call Q factor as omega divided by 2 delta omega. If I say no, if it is, it should be omega divided by 2 delta omega whole square. Can you object it? No. Still, all the observation, all the arguments still make sense. Lesser the delta omega, better will be the quality factor still.
So,
I'm squaring it. Okay? So I am taking the simplest of all expression for quality factor, which is this. Write down. Omega naught divided by 2 delta omega.
Okay. Omega naught being the peak.
Omega naught is a resonant.
Yeah, 1 by root 6, by the
way. Resonant frequency is this. Getting it? Okay, now can you get the value of frequency for these two points? This is point number one and this is point number two. Current is what? I naught is.
Would it I naught be the same at that point?
Right now, first. V naught divided by 1 by omega c minus omega l whole square. R square. This is the curve equation. Are you getting it? This is a relation between current and voltage. This is how the current will change if you change the frequency. This is the equation of the curve. Okay. You want to find out information about these two points. You want to find omega for that. What you should put I naught as?
V naught by root 2
R. Because V0 by root 2 R, if you substitute this,
point, yeah.
Yeah, if you substitute this current in that curve equation, you'll get these two points or not.
Yeah.
Right? So I'm going to substitute I0 as V0 by root 2 R. Now can you simplify it a bit? Don't just theoretically talk. Do it in your notebook. Okay, so if you square it, if you square both sides, you will get, before squaring, I can cancel out V0, okay, and then take it in the numerator, and then if I square, I'll get 1 by omega C minus omega L whole square plus R square is equal to 2R square. All of you got this? okay? So you will get 1 divided by omega c minus omega l is equal to, I mean, plus minus r, but let's take it the positive value right now, okay? If you take minus r, you will get 1 point. If you get plus r, you get another point. So even if you get 1 point, it is symmetrical. You will automatically get the other one. Getting it? Okay? Now, these two values, when you solve, you get omega for 1 or 2. Are you getting it? This equation is satisfied by these two frequencies. Fine. Now, there is a small trick over here, which is not very common, but then you remember once you use it once. So omega, you write in terms of omega naught. How will I write? Omega is equal to omega naught plus minus delta omega. Write this down.
Isn't this from AOI rate of change?
What?
The same equation is used in rate of change.
What?
AOI? Delta x plus or minus.
No, this is not that. Don't get into all that. Delta omega will assume is very less compared to omega naught. We are assuming that the sharpness is good enough for us to ignore delta omega as compared to omega naught. Getting it? So if I substitute this in that, and if I use this approximation, can you get the value of delta omega? Try to do it,
So what do you mean, delta omega value?
You have to first write down something, do it yourself, and then speak about it. Okay? Otherwise, you will not learn anything. If you don't do it yourself, once you get stuck, then you ask. Don't just keep on asking few things which you haven't arrived there as yet. It's there in your textbook also, you can refer that. Don't just look at the board and copy it down. Now, do you remember binomial approximation? This minus 1 will come inside. Do you know this? So remember this approximation. This is widely used. 1 plus x raised to power y is approximately equal to 1 plus xy if mod of x is very less than 1, I mean if it x is like 0.001, then you can use this approximation. Okay, have you learned binomial theorem? Okay, it's a part of that. Fine, I'll rub this part. So if I apply binomial approximation out there, I'll get 1 by omega naught c 1 minus plus this is equal to r. Okay, so if I further simplify it, I'll get 1 by omega naught c minus omega naught l, this is omega naught, minus plus this, you understand? How much is this? What is the value of this?
R.
But ye zero hai na? At omega naught, xc will become equal to xl or not? This term is zero. And how much is this? This particular thing. And can you convert this in terms of L? Omega naught square is what? 1 by LC? So it becomes delta omega L. So you will have 2 times delta omega L is equal to R. Okay, and I'll write this omega naught square. If I just consider the magnitude, then 2 times delta omega is nothing but fine. So we have got a simple expression for the width. So Q factor will be what? Q factor should be omega naught divided by 2 delta omega, right? So this will be omega naught L by R. And this is dimensionless, no dimension, because this is frequency divided by frequency. Let me know if you have any doubts on this.
It's supposed to be omega naught plus or minus delta omega, right? First step. This step above.
Oh, yeah, I mean, see, we are anyway taking mod at the end. You could have just taken plus, everywhere plus. You would have arrived the same way. We want the magnitude of this. Any other doubt? Fine, so this is another difficult derivation, probably if you find. This is one of those derivation people don't do it properly. This one, and analytical solution of LCR.